story has obviously been blowing up all across the nation, especially around college football and locally. It's been kind of crazy. And time to bring in our good friend Chris Bond of ArkansasSports360.com. And Chris, have you ever seen anything like this before?
No. You've seen the aftermath of coaching changes or coaching searches, which are usually pretty hectic. But when you start getting state police involved in football matters, it's a little different than anything we've seen before.
Are you surprised by everything that's going on? Arkansas is a school that's usually tight-lipped about what goes on in its sports program. And then to have all of this happen, I'm sure that it's a shock to really all of us that cover it.
Sure. And Coach Petrino has been a very private man. He's been a guy who really keeps to football and family, doesn't let out a lot of outsiders in. And now, because of these circumstances, he's got to share his very, private life with the public. So, yeah, it's a different, thing than we're used to.
We've heard a lot of the sports talk shows. We just heard from some people calling into a sports talk show in Fort Smith and heard a lot of people say, hey, maybe this is his own personal business. Maybe this should just be Bobby Petrino and his family. But really, it's about a program. It could affect the way people are recruited and so on. It could affect Arkansas football.
When Bobby came in, he came in with a reputation as a guy who was dishonest and disloyal. He's really fought to overcome that. And now that starts to creep back in. You can bet Nick Saban and Les Miles will be using this to their advantage in recruiting to try to, recruit against Arkansas. I think it could have a very profound impact on how Bobby can conduct his job.
Now, you wrote an article today on ArkansasSports360.com about maybe some contract ramifications that Bobby may have crossed the line with. Tell us about that.
It's very open-ended, the contract language. Arkansas essentially, and to paraphrase, they can choose what's conduct unbecoming a representative of the University of Arkansas. If they choose that, if they decide that Bobby did violate the contract, they could fire him. Or, there are other stipulations like suspend him with pay, without pay, take away some of his bonuses and those sorts of things.
It's been crazy. What do you think happens next?
I don't know. I'm like everybody else. I want to wait and see what Jeff Long does with his review. I think, we'll see something in the next week or two, and we'll find out from there.
You've been busy.
Yeah.
Chris Bond of ArkansasSports360.com and CBAHN on Twitter. I follow him all the time because he's got all the latest on the Arkansas Razorbacks. So